People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, can somebody explain to me why Peter Phillips and Peter Bunting just spent millions on a bunch of polls that are completely useless? Maybe them have it like that. Maybe them just have the money for burn. Now, you're asking me, what do you mean these polls are useless? Well, they are, and I will tell you why. First of all, how much or how accurate polls are is still up for debate. And we've seen historically that the polls don't often reflect what happened on election day. If you remember, some of the polls when Hillary Clinton was running against Donald Trump, some of the polls had Hillary Clinton destroying Donald Trump. And we all saw how that one turned out. But these polls are a waste of time, because if you notice, one, when Bunting paid for his poll, or when Bunting commissioned a poll, the results came back and said Bunting is the man. And then when Peter Phillips commissioned his poll, the polls came back and said Peter Phillips is the man. So that alone right there should tell you all you need to know about polls and how accurate they are, right? Now, as far as I'm aware, the way how PNP president is elected is that it is done by the delegates. It's not the individual MPs come out and vote and say, I back this man, I back that one. And then if 15 MP vote for one and 6 MP vote for the other, the one in 15 becomes the leader. That's not how it works for the PNP, right? It is the delegates who decide who becomes the PNP president. And since the contest is for PNP president, why were these polls being done on a national basis? Why were these pollsters going around questioning PNP, JLP, neutrals, man who no vote? How that makes sense? How would that give you an accurate reflection of how the delegates are going to vote when you're asking people who don't even care about the PNP? You're asking people who has never voted and will never vote. This is why I said these polls are a waste of time and a waste of money. See, what they should have done is said, we're going to take 1,000 delegates or 1,500 delegates, and we're going to ask them, how are you voting come September 7th? Right? And then from that, we will then say, okay, 60% of the delegates say they're voting for this one, and 40 say they're voting for the next. And if two of them commission these polls, then we can at least match up the numbers. But these people who they were speaking to in these polls, most of them now have nothing to do with PNP. They were treating it like it was a general election, as if it's going to be an election between JLP and PNP for who is going to get governance of the country. Some of the questions were about Andrew Holness and the JLP, and are you happy with Holness? I'm like, what does that have to do with the PNP president? It was a waste of time. We've learned nothing new. All this extra information, 46% of Jamaicans, the latest Bill Johnson one said 46% of Jamaicans say the country's heading in the wrong way. And how, Andrew Holness shouldn't be comfortable. I'm like, okay, cool. But what does that have to do with the PNP presidential race? What does that have to do with showing us who is more likely to win come September the 7th? This is not between Andrew Holness and Peter Bunting and Peter Phillips. This is between Phillips and Bunting. This is an in-house battle. So why you gonna commission a poll for millions? And for those of you who don't know, listen. Commissioning a poll costs millions of dollars. It's very expensive to commission a poll. Because are you responsible for the team that's doing the polling? You're responsible for the when them charge you, they're charging you for their expenses for every community them travel to. They might factor in them gas, they might factor in the time them spend on roadside to stop people. It's very expensive. Trust me. Right? So Bunting did his one first. And newsflash, the man tell Bunting what Bunting want here. Then Peter Phillips did his poll. And newsflash, Bill Johnson tell Peter Bunting what Peter Bunting want here. But as for the people, those of us who don't have a dog in the fight, we've learned nothing new. This should have been exclusive to PNP delegates. This should have been exclusive to PNP, the current communities that are being run by PNP MPs. That's where these polls should have taken place. Or if you're going to run a West Kingston Gawks man about who Bunting and Phillips, they're not here, they're not vote either. But then again, maybe I'm not totally understanding how the PNP elects its leaders. So I'd love it if somebody could educate me. Because I must be getting it totally wrong. Because surely, two senior politicians like Bunting and Phillips could not make such a foolish mistake like this. To commission a national poll to decide who's going to be the next PNP president. That was the goal of this whole gimmicks, you know. Because in my opinion, polls are gimmicks. They mean nothing. Election day is the only thing that matters. Right? But people love the suspense and people love to see the numbers and go, oh, wow, he my lead. Okay, cool, I get it. But it's still a gimmicks. But when they commission this poll, what they wanted is to get the numbers and then to see, I'm in the lead and the delegates are going to vote for me. But how would you know that if you're asking labor rights and neutrals and people who know business about politics? When you look at some of the answers for these polls, a lot of the people are like, I don't know. A lot of people just don't know and don't care. Enough Jamaicans have given up on politics, you know. This is what people don't realize. A lot of Jamaicans have given up on politics. They've given up on the PNP. They've given up on the Labour and Liberalism. When you ask them nothing about politics, they get mad. If I even stop them and say, excuse me, what do you think about the most I get is that I don't know. Right? But if they had kept this poll to the delegates, they wouldn't be getting all these I don't know and I don't show and I don't, because the delegates are already politically active. The delegates will give you an answer. And not only will they give you an answer in this poll, but come September, they are going to be able to cast their vote and actually have a real effect. So that is why, in my opinion, these polls were a waste of time and a waste of money. We have learned nothing new from these polls, except that when you commission somebody for this something and you pay them, they usually tell you what you want to hear. That's the only thing I've taken away from this. Two different teams, the two different polls, within a very short space of time and come out with two different answers. That's all you need to see that this thing should not be taken seriously. But I guess them have the money like that for burn. That's the only thing I can look at. I'm sure neither Bunting nor Peter Phillips are struggling to make ends meet, and they have their various backers who are donating to either campaign. Bunting is a successful businessman, and he has a lot of wealthy backers. Don't underestimate Bunting. People are more about Bunting pockets deep like the ocean. And Peter Phillips has his backers as well. So, I guess they must have the money and just want to burn up some. But I haven't seen any information that tell me which direction the delegates are going to swing come September. We've learned nothing new. But that's just my opinion. Let me know what you think. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.